Hey everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the gastrocnemius muscle.
Here we can see pictured the gastrocnemius muscle in isolation. And the gastrocnemius muscle has two heads. We've got a medial head here, and then the lateral head. And you'll notice that the medial head is slightly thicker, slightly wider than the lateral head. The gastrocnemius is also part of the calf muscle group, and you've probably heard of the calf muscles before, as they generally refer to the muscles on the back of the leg. Now, the calf muscles are comprised of the gastrocnemius, which we can see here, but they're also comprised of the soleus muscle as well. And here we can see the soleus muscle in isolation. The soleus muscle is just deep to the gastrocnemius, so it's just underneath it. These calf muscles are sometimes referred to as the triceps surae. Now, tri usually means three, so you're probably wondering why it's triceps surae, considering there's only two muscles in this group. Well, it's because it's counting the heads of the muscles here rather than the muscles itself. And the gastrocnemius, it has two heads. Soleus has one head, so that's where the triceps part of the name comes from. Another thing to note about these two muscles is that they both join together to create the calcaneal tendon. And you've probably heard of the calcaneal tendon before, but referred to as the Achilles tendon or perhaps the Achilles heel. So you can see I've highlighted the calcaneal tendon here in green. So the gastrocnemius muscle is going to come down here, connect into that calcaneal tendon will continue down the leg, merge with the soleus muscle as well, and then they're both going to come down and they're going to connect onto the calcaneus here, which is also sometimes referred to as the heel bone. Next, you can see I've marked out the origins here in red. So our medial head of the gastrocnemius is going to originate on the medial condyle of the femur, and the lateral head is going to originate on the lateral condyle of the femur. So between the two condyles and the supracondylar lines, we have a slightly roughened area of bone, which is referred to as the popliteal surface. So the popliteal surface is somewhat triangular in shape. I'm just going to highlight the outside border of the popliteal surface with my cursor here, and you'll notice that the origin points just slightly touch onto the popliteal surface. So that's why the popliteal surface is also considered an origin point of the gastrocnemius muscle. So now we can see the insertion point marked out here in blue. And you'll remember that the gastrocnemius muscle comes down and connects into the calcaneal tendon, and it's the calcaneal tendon which joins with the soleus muscle and then connects onto the calcaneus. So the gastrocnemius is connecting onto the calcaneus, but it's doing so via that calcaneal tendon.
So let's take a look at the actions next. So gastrocnemius is crossing over the knee joint, and it's also crossing over the ankle joint. At the moment, you can see the ankle joint is in a dorsiflex position. So dorsiflexion is when the ankle joint flexes. And you can see the blue insertion marked out on the back of the calcaneus here. And then the gastrocnemius is going to run up here, connect onto that origin on the back of the femur. So you can imagine its contraction is going to pull on the calcaneus, and then that's going to extend the ankle joint out like that. Now, that extension of the ankle joint is referred to as plantarflexion. So the first and primary action of the gastrocnemius is plantarflexion of the ankle joint. And you can imagine that's going to be a useful movement in walking, in running, jumping, anything which requires transmitting power through that sort of emotion there. Now, the gastrocnemius is also crossing over the knee joint, so we're going to have an action there as well. It's crossing over the posterior of the knee joint, so as it contracts, it's going to squeeze, and then that's going to cause flexion of the knee joint, just like that. Now, it's going to be an assistive role comparative to other much stronger flexors of the knee joint, such as the hamstring muscles, for example. They're much more powerful flexors of the knee joint, but the gastrocnemius is still able to assist if it needs to. So, thanks very much for watching, everyone. If you've enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there. Really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching. See you all next time.